Hello everyone, I am Rohit. I, on behalf of Surovino Society, would like to welcome all the teachers to one of the most successful and innovative idea sharing platform of India, ZIIEI, that is Zero Investment Innovation for Education Initiative. Here, we will be discussing about new and innovative techniques for different lessons from our chapters, and in short, we will learn how to make the whole process of learning fun and interesting for the kids. Today, the chapter that I'll be covering is from Class 5 NCERT report, subject is Environmental Studies, and the name of the lesson is Seeds from Seeds. The innovation that I'll be using here for covering this lesson is known as What's in a Picture. The main innovation behind using this idea is to increase the linguistic skills of the students with the help of different picture cards, and in turn help the students understanding the concepts that has been taught in the lesson. It also acts as a visual aid for the students. The duration for this activity will be one period of 40 minutes and three more periods of 10 minutes observation or 5 minutes observation each. Some of the important concepts that we'll be covering with the help of this innovation are plants from foreign countries, dispersion of seeds, learning of the properties and various features of seeds. Before implementing this idea, we need to make some pre-arrangements. We'll be preparing for the pre-arrangements are, we'll be preparing picture cards, we'll be having picture cards. In a set one, we'll be having picture cards of tomato, chilies, green chilies, potato, cabbage, green peas, then coffee beans, then bhindi, then mango, orange, banana, methi. In a picture card 2, we'll be having magnified images of mustard seeds, cumin seeds, rajma seeds, dandelion, and cotton. In the third set, explaining about the dispersion of seeds, we'll be having images of burdock, cherry, nut, and coconut. In a fourth set, we'll be having picture cards of rajma seeds soaked in water, another picture card of rajma seeds, expanded rajma seeds, and the third picture card, we'll be having sprouted rajma seeds. Then we'll be needing some seeds of rajma seeds, original rajma seeds. Along with this, we'll be also having a world map. We'll be needing a world map. I want to make a point here that the picture cards that we'll be having preparing for this innovation should have the names below it. Okay, first of all, we'll focus on giving the students the concept about the transfer of plants from foreign countries. We ask the students that what kind of vegetables and fruits do you have at your home. We take the responses, then we tell the students they will respond banana, bhindi, brinjal, tomato, etc. We ask the students that are these vegetables from India. We take the responses. We tell the students that all these vegetables are not from India, and today we'll be learning from where these vegetables are from, the origin of these vegetables and plants. We call out a few students and we give them the first set of picture cards, and then we make a chart in the blackboard writing the name of the vegetables and fruits that we have brought. Along corresponding to it, we'll also write the name of the country origin. And while we say out the name of the vegetables and fruits and their origin, the students will be sticking those picture cards in the country, the corresponding country. Say, suppose for example, we say tomatoes. Once upon a time, tomato came from South America with potato and green chilies. So the students will go and stick the picture card of tomato, potato and green chilies in the South America. Then we can say that cabbage and peas came from Europe. Then they will stick it in the Europe and so on. We start saying about the picture cards, and simultaneously the students will sticking out the picture cards in the corresponding countries. We inform the students that these fruits and vegetables have been brought to India by different traders before a long time back. Then we move on to the next step, that is teaching the students about the features of seeds. We show them the big magnified images of the cumin seeds, zira seeds, dandelion and cotton. We ask the students, can you name these picture cards? Then they might respond. They might be able to respond about zira, then cumin seeds and all. Then we ask them that, do you know about the other two picture cards? We show them the dandelion and cotton. If they do not know, we inform them that these are known as dandelion and cotton. And then we make the students do one activity. We ask the students to write in the notebooks, observe the picture cards properly, and make a chart in the copy of of the and noting down the features of these plants. Like for example, they will write dandelion, then its color, its shape, and its special feature. Suppose in a special feature, it has got hair-like structures. Then for dandelion, we'll ask the students that, can you tell me why these hair-like structures are for? We let the students respond. We inform the students that the hair-like structures of the dandelion helps the seeds of this plant to travel to different places through air, so that it can grow in other places also. Similarly, we can also ask questions for the other seeds, other picture cards, other seeds to the students. Next, we move on to teaching the students about the dispersion of seeds. We tell the students that it's not only the traders who have brought the seeds from other countries, there are other processes also. And for that, we show them the picture cards of burdock, cherry, nut, and cotton. And then we make a chart in the blackboard. And then we start explaining the students that how the seeds stick to the fur of animals in case of burdock, and how the seeds that are eaten by birds and lift away the seeds and leads to the growth of cherry plants, how these plants travel from place to place by different means. We give them this concept. Next, we move on to giving the students the understanding about growth of plants from seeds. For this, we use the picture cards of rasma seeds. We first show them the picture cards, and then we initiate the activity with the students. We ask the students to soak the rasma seeds overnight, and next day we ask them what they have observed. Then they might respond that it have expanded. Once it becomes expanded, we tell the students that now we'll be putting the seeds in a wet cotton. We make them put in a wet cotton and ask them to observe until and unless they see some changes. And once they see changes in them, we ask them to note down all the observations and see how this rasma seeds have started sprouting and growing into a plant. We ask them to make all these observations. Apart from this, we also give the students an understanding about pitcher plants, how these plants survive on small insects and plants for their survivability, irrespective of other plants who survive on water. And this way, we continue with the class, giving the students a concept about all the things that have been taught in the lesson through a visual way with the help of different picture cards. And when we start teaching the students in this way, we start getting a lot of learning outcomes. Apart from understanding the lesson in a much more better way, we will be converting the whole class into a fun and interesting one. And also, it will help in the development of critical thinking and decision-making process among the students. Along with this, it will also help in the development of interpersonal skills and communication skills of the students. And they will also learn how to communicate to simple instructions that have been made in English. And for this innovation, this idea, that's all. I hope you like this video. And if you want more of such videos from us, please do like, share, and subscribe to our official channel, ZIIEI. Thank you.